Hello, what's up, wizards and witches? We are back in another adventure in Hogwarts Legacy. Keep up with likes and support. And if you are new to my channel, please hit the subscribe button. I will be very grateful. And let's continue, right? We finished just a story quest line. That was very nice. It's already finished. I mean, almost, I guess. All right, we have something still. Prepare for your owls. All right, so two more quests from here. Talk to Professor Weasley. Oh, and we have this one. We can speak to Sebastian, and we will finish this relationship quests with him, I guess. Yeah, let's go over there. Let's speak with him. Right here.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Yes, we are. And now we will have a lot of side quests to finish, so yeah. There will be much to do. And of course collecting all those pages, that will be the longest journey, I guess, to platinum with this. All right,
I'm glad you came.
Peek with him.
Sebastian, I've received your owl. What's happened?
Ominous spoke with Anne about what happened with my uncle Solomon. She believes I should pay for what I did, but she won't turn me in. She said the guilt I'll have to live with is punishment enough.
I'm so sorry. But I'm glad you know that you can at least try to move on now.
The thing is, I think I've lost my sister, my twin, forever. She refuses to even see me. I can't blame her. I couldn't really blame any of you if you gave up on me entirely. You all believed in me, and I let you all down.
Yeah, perhaps she will come around with time. She need time, like everybody.
Anne may just need some time. Surely one day she'll be able to forgive you.
I hope you're right. I realize I can't undo what's been done, but I can try every day to make up for it. I owe you and Ominous everything for standing by me.
Well, it wasn't easy, but I believe in you, Sebastian. I've had a sense about you since that first day in Defense Against the Dark Arts.
Seems so long ago. Thank you. I have no idea what's to come, but I'm grateful for your friendship. I'm glad you came
problem.
To Hogwarts.
Alright, a Sallow Grave trophy earned. Just for completing his relationship questline. Alright, nice. Yeah. That was that. So let's go with this, I guess. Yeah, let's see. What do we have to do? And what is it all about? We need to win the House Cup, I guess. That would be really nice.
I suppose one could smile.
But I am wondering how.
The headmaster should know compassion.
How we can do that. Alright. Well, Professor Weasley, where are you? Right in her room. Whoa, those doors just closed. Hello.
Professor Weasley, you wanted to see me?
I did. We haven't had a chance to speak since I know you were quite close with Professor Fig.
Hogwarts won't be the same without him.
No, it won't. But I can assure you that he would want us to press on. And that he would rest easy knowing that the future of the wizarding world is in hands like yours.
Thank you, Professor.
You've had quite a year, both inside and outside of Hogwarts. I've heard all sorts of rumors. You've ridden a graphorn, befriended a goblin, rescued hippogriffs, even somehow ingratiated yourself with the headless hunt.
How did you...
It's harder to keep secrets around here than one might suspect. No need to discuss it further. What I would like to discuss is your wizard's field guide. May I see it?
Of course. What do you think, Professor?
I think you've been busy this year. I see some progress here, but quite a bit of your field guide has yet to be completed. Fortunately, you do have some time to prepare for your OWLs. I will confess, I had a sense about you from that first moment you came bursting in, late, to the sorting ceremony. I am pleased to see that my instincts were correct. To think you've only been with us a year and you'll already be taking your OWLs, well, it's nothing short of astonishing.
Thank you, Professor, for everything.
You are most welcome. I look forward to seeing what you do during the rest of your time with us.
Yes, I know. I have a lot to complete yet. All right. Well, that quest was really fast. And what is another one? Oh, reach level 34. And that's it. All right, so we will have time. Yeah, we need to finish a lot of side quests and yes, other things like collect those pages, right? All right, oh, let's go for that one. Yeah, summoner's card, match number 2. Let's see how difficult it will be this time. Probably very difficult. I'm not sure. Let's see. Hello?
Oh, what I would...
Hello, Samantha. Are you here for someone's court?
I am. I'm hoping to get my brother out here soon, too, since, thanks to you, he's recovered from his, vegetative state.
Glad to hear it.
In all fairness, I must warn you that I am frightfully good. Shall we begin?
Yeah. We shall.
Yes, I'm ready to play.
Then let's get summoning.
Wait, what is that?
Akia!
All right, I see.
Yes!
Huh. Amazing. So let's do it like shit. Not sure. Okay, yes. All right.
That was sensational.
Yeah, that wasn't too hard. What the? Well, that was strange.
Yes.
Yes, yes, indeed. Well, I cannot do that here. I need to do it to this side. Yes. Let's go. No! Further! Come on! Oh, yes? 50?
How am I to top that?
Oh, 30 only? Come on. Hit my ball. Oh, what the hell? Come on, get the hell out of the way. Shit. Oh, man, that's... not good at all. What did you just do? All right, let's hit my own ball. Or okay, yeah, like that is good as well.
How am I to top that?
You have no more
it, then.
options. Right. Barely, but we made it.
After your poor show against Natty in class, I thought I could beat you. Appears I overestimated myself.
Don't say that, Samantha. You're a fine player.
Well, that's very kind of you. Let's just say if I'm good, then you're better. I happen to know who you're up against next, and she's no shy opponent. Best of luck.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So, where is she? Where is the next opponent? Somewhere, that's for sure, right? We can go for another one, right? Why not? They are going too fast. What's that? Alright, yeah. Okay, oh. Attend the history of magic class. Well, that's interesting. So we still have some classes to do. Damn. Oh boy.
Rebellion.
Was I here already? No. I am seeing that class for the first time. Oh, what is that?
Alohomora.
Some locks on doors? That's insane. Right. What is that place? Jeez. There's a butterfly here. Nice. Oh. Phoenix statue. Oh, that's nice. Oh. It didn't show. What kind of a page is that? Oh, that's strange.
Leviosa. Revelio.
What do we have out here? Some room. Because I can see it on the mini-map. Or the Pulso puzzle room 2. Okay, yes. There was somewhere this room 1.
Revelio.
I'm wondering, where is this painting with the butterfly?
Alohomora.
Good, good, very good.
Rebellion.
Just a chest and some note, okay. Like that, okay, and some shitty item. Yeah, well, what can you do? I guess that's it. Right here. Let's try to enter from here to this. Okay, yeah.
Revelio.
Let's begin.
We will cover a truly thrilling event. The Goblin Rebellion of 1752 and all its triumphant tragedy. But more specifically, we will address the devastating effects it had on the wizard's
Jesus Christ.
To
I will fall asleep. No, please.
Countless wizard cloaks were lost. Actually, we do know the number. 632. But history occurs outside the classroom. And look, it's
so
time
exciting.
For my constitutional. One can practically osmosis flowing through Hogwarts.
I think the professor wants us to follow him.
Oh, right. So
now for a stroll to the bell tower entrance hall.
Let's.
Along with the rest of the castle, it was completed in the late early Middle Ages. The hall and the bell towers that loom above it contain myriad interesting artifacts.
Professor, where are you? Oh, right here.
Revelio.
Good to see you again. Recovered from that nasty bout of dragon pox, have we?
That wasn't me, Professor. I'm new here.
Are you? Well then, welcome. No doubt you're eagerly anticipating my analysis of various wizarding councils, codes, statutes, and of course, goblin rebellions. Not all goblins are rebellious. Some venture into wizarding politics, such as Irgit the Ugly. Some are talented artisans, such as Bragbor the Boastful.
Did you say Bragbor? I know that name. Lord Gok said he was an ancestor of Ranrok.
Well known for his metalwork. I would imagine much of his goblin wrought iron and silver has survived to this very day. Where were we? Oh yes. Back to our class topic for today. Grimbold Weft, another notable historical figure. He's right nearby.
Oh my god, can you speak faster?
Curious students can find him on display here in the bell tower entrance hall.
Revelio.
This unassuming smudge is rumored to be the location of the very first successful use of Bombarda. I suppose successful is a relative term, since whoever cast it didn't live.
Where is it? Oh, no. This one? Yes.
Oh, yes. I see you found Grimbold Weft.
Yes, I rather enjoyed seeking him out.
The thrill of the scholarly pursuit. I know the feeling quite well. Now, let's turn our attention to the agreeability and general good nature of Sir Athbuddle. He's also nearby. See what you can learn from him for your next assignment.
My standing next in assignment?
Shit. A retinue of loyal knights, or rather, statues of knights, I should clarify.
Sir Athbuddle, this is a centuries-old likeness of Pandemon.
Statue of Sir Athbuddle.
This one? That's a waving knight. It wasn't that one, right?
Jeez. Slaying bloodthirsty dragons.
I took already those ones over here.
Left of a witch called Celine Wartnobby.
Where his warm and approachable demeanor was celebrated by old
those here as well.
I encourage one to make the waving statue's acquaintance.
Oh, okay, that was the one. Waving statue. Now we need to go back to him, it says.
Professor Binns, I found the statue of Sir Athpuddle.
Ah, well done. Alas, Sir Athpuddle's affability was his undoing. Died instantly trying to befriend a basilisk. Eye contact is not always to be encouraged. So beloved was he that even some goblins mourned his passing. Of course, that did not bode well with the rest of the goblins, most of whom could not abide mourning the loss of a wizard.
Pity goblins and wizards can't get along.
True. But imagine how dull my lectures would be without goblin rebellions to discuss. History does tend to repeat. It is a series of patterns, a thought both comforting and disconcerting. The wise student, such as yourself, will learn from it.
Oh, luckily it's over. Jesus.
History is written by those who do their schoolwork, so they say. Or at least...
Yeah, something like that. Oh boy, I feel so sleepy right now. Jesus. Okay, so we did that. What else? There's nothing more. Oh boy, why? There was more quests over here. Very strange.
Say that.
Well, maybe. Maybe let's go to. Wait, oh yeah, now I can see them. Okay, that was very strange. Yeah, what the hell? What the hell just happened? That's the one. There's no more over here. And we... Yes, we did over here as well. So this one left. We need to talk with a portrait. That's insane.
I've been kidnapped.
What? You've been kidnapped? Oh my god. They are keeping you in a portrait. Yeah, that's a prison cell.
Sir, are you all right? You seem to be in some distress.
All right? Do I look all right? I've been kidnapped.
How can you be kidnapped when you're right here?
What sort of question is that? Of course I'm right here. I've more than one frame. Do you only have one home? It's my other frame. It's been stolen. And by students, no less. They paid filthy fees to steal my other frame.
What the hell?
Oh dear. That sounds awful.
Well, awful is exactly what Astoria Cricket is. She's behind all of this. She and her friends were moaning about me of all the nerve. Then I heard a plot to enlist a gang of good-for-nothings to have me stolen from the three broomsticks. That's why my other frame hung. Hovel of a place. Though I suppose one could do worse. I once knew a portrait who ended up in the Hog's Head. No one's heard from him since.
Right. So back to your frame.
Ah, yes. There I was, powdering my wig, and the next thing I knew, I was being manhandled by rogues and carried off. As if I can afford not to be at my post. I do important work for the headmaster, and I need my other frame back at the Three Broomsticks.
Well, well.
Just who is Astoria Cricket, and what would she want with your frame?
She's a fourth-year troublemaker, that's who. She and her band of hoodlums discuss all sorts of misdeeds right under my nose, and then resent me for overhearing them. I can only assume they took my frame in some misguided attempt to punish me for doing my job.
What do you mean you do important work for the headmaster?
Let's just say I overhear quite a bit in Serona's fine establishment. And the headmaster likes to know all about it. He's come to count on me in this regard. Reminds me of my prefect days.
I don't suppose you have any idea where your stolen frame was taken. Can you see anything from it?
They most certainly can. They brought me to a ruin of all places. Some crumbling atrocity surrounded by water from the sound of it. Oh, I do also recall seeing the coast on the way.
A coast, all right.
I could look into the matter for you.
Oh, would you? How marvelous. Do it quickly though, won't you? The place they took me to is quite beneath me. Off you go then.
Now off we go then, yes. All right. Jesus, take it easy. Yeah, no quests, Hogsmeade. Three broomsticks, all right. We have some side quests here as well, of course, in Hogsmeade.
Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade.
Oh, here she is.
Astoria Cricket?
That depends. Am I in trouble?
Ferdinand Pratt thinks you should be. Says you stole his frame.
I wouldn't call it stolen. Relocated's more like it. How do I put this nicely? Ferdinand Pratt is a pustulant boil, and he's lucky I didn't have him sealed in a wall.
He truly is rather foul, isn't he?
All he does is spy on students in here and report back to the headmaster. Sometimes, if there's nothing to report, he'll make it up. I spent 4 hours in detention last week, all because he told Black that I was planning to drain the lake, whatever that means. It was the last straw. He and his frame had to go.
May I ask where you put him?
Well, I didn't put him anywhere. The frame is likely with the fine gents I paid to snatch it. They camp in a ruin by the coast. I just wanted it far enough away that I'd never have to think about Ferdinand Pratt ever again.
You do know he's screaming in the library as we speak.
Oh, for the love of Merlin. If you ask me, he's got nothing to scream about. I could have had him put in the hog's head. The pampered Pratt would have hated it. Grimy walls, smell of goats. And the patrons, they eat snooty princes like Ferdinand for dinner. But what's done is done. He isn't here anymore, and if I were you, I should enjoy it.
Well, what can we
do
now?
Lovely chatting with you.
Find the ruins, I think we will have option what to do with this frame when we will get it. Alright, let's find those ruins. Whoa, oh my god. Wow, that's crazy. He's far away from home. Oh boy, what's that? Flying monsters?
I'll check your pockets after you're dead.
Handy resource.
Right, moonstones, and we need to go up. Okay. But here we have some even more. Nice. And in front of us as well. Damn. For what do I need that many? Jesus, those are the ruins. I believe, yes.
Rebellion.
Whoa. Let's stay hidden, perhaps.
He's going to part with some gold.
My mother used to...
No one's going to pay a ransom for that portrait.
Okay. He saw that she's missing, or what the hell?
Revelio.
We've made our money.
Now let's burn him and be done with it.
Somebody out there?
Nobody. Why?
I won't make the same.
Jesus, sorry for that.
You've made a grave mistake, stupid one.
Whoa. A chicken? Perfect. Boy, that was good. And you can die now. Alright. Thank you for your help. Awesome. Alright, and we have here a Merlin trial as well. That's very nice. Yeah, maybe I will do it first, right?
I know a Merlin trial when I see one.
Yeah, just simply take those butterflies. That's very, very easy. This one over here, and another one was there. All right, where are the butterflies? Oh, right there. Oh boy, do I have to jump or what?
Lumos.
Yeah, come with me.
That's that.
That's that indeed. All right, and those ruins, we need to go down here.
Revelio.
Where is it? Through here? Oh, maybe. Oh well, I don't think so. God damn.
This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
Find him in the ruins. So, where is he in those ruins? Somewhere underground?
Revelio.
Well, that's... Oh, shit. Yes. Of course. Right here.
Lumos. Alohomora.
Locked, of course. Let's speak with that guy.
Calm down, I'm here now.
Calm down? Those buffoons outside have been talking about burning me. Me! If they weren't all sharing half a brain, they'd realize I'm worth more to them intact and at the three broomsticks.
How is that?
With everything I overhear, I'm a veritable trove of information. Now, don't just stand there. I need to be back by cocktail hour. The place will be like a funeral without me.
Well, Returning you to the three broomstick isn't my only option, yes.
What if I don't want to return you to the three broomsticks?
What on earth do you mean?
I could burn you. I could head you to the Hog's Head. Yes, Hog's Head.
What if I took you to the Hog's Head instead? I've heard such nice things.
What a funny little joke. Now, the three broomsticks, please. Oh, they're bound to be missing me terribly. Be sure to carry me carefully, won't you? My pantaloons are already creased. Where have you put me? It's pitch black in here.
Oh, come on.
I shan't stand for this.
Oh, wait. Take Ferdinand's frame to the three broomsticks or the Hog's Head. Yeah. Well, dude, you will be surprised. Hog's Head it is. Yep. Let's do that. Oh, that will be nice. Yes, I was hoping for an option like that.
Sorry if I catch a flea.
Very
Are
nice.
You listening to me? Get me out.
Of course I am. Or I have a perfect place for you. Don't worry. Don't worry.
What is the meaning of this? This isn't the three broomsticks.
No, it's not. It's the Hog's Head.
Did you fall into a cauldron of stupid potion? You've brought me to the wrong place. It's absolutely vile in here.
That is your new home.
It's no three broomsticks, that's for certain.
Please, you can't mean to leave me here. Please.
Goodbye, Ferdinand. Enjoy your new home.
And what will the honors
say? I normally toss the both of you out. But I like the look of the fancy man. Target practice.
Please, you can't use me as target practice anymore.
Why not? That's fantastic. Yep. Well, karma's bitch, right? Shit. All right. Fantastic. Let's let's see what else can we do. That was in Hogwarts, right? What else is out here? Oh boy, so many quests in here as well. Oh, let's check that one.
Why did I never learn how to swim?
How to swim? What the hell?
Going for a swim?
Goodness no. Though I'm beginning to think I really should learn how to swim. Can't very well be liaison to the merpeople if I don't know how to swim.
You're a liaison to the merpeople?
Well, not technically, no. At least not yet. The position doesn't actually exist at the moment, but I have a plan to change that. I'm Nerida, by the way. Nerida Roberts. We didn't officially meet, but we duelled in the Crossed Wands Club.
Yes, of course. Good to see you again.
And you.
You seem quite interested in merpeople.
I am. And they're as misunderstood and disregarded by wizard kind as goblins and centaurs are. I feel that if goblins and centaurs have liaison officers at the ministry, then the merpeople should have one too.
I'm impressed. I think reaching out to the merpeople is a grand idea.
You do? Oh, thank you. Of course, I haven't exactly done anything just yet. I presented them with a gift a few weeks ago, and they wanted to leave me one as well, in one of their caves. Reciprocity and an offer to visit. I tried telling them I couldn't swim, but I'm afraid that bit got lost in translation. Mermish really is tricky.
All right, so we have now some questions.
How has wizard kind fallen short in its treatment of mer people?
Well, we've consistently deigned mer people as being beneath us despite the many similarities between our cultures. One can hardly blame them for declining being status by the ministry years ago. Who are we to classify those of such beauty and intelligence?
What do you imagine a liaison to the Mer people would do?
Oh, so many things. I want to know everything I can about them. After I've mastered swimming, I perfect my Mermish, of course. And I'd share with them anything they wanted to know about wizardkind. My hope is that by understanding each other better, both of our societies could grow.
What is it about the Mer people that interests you so much?
I can't begin to tell you how brilliant they are. I mean, rumor is that tales about them have infiltrated even the Muggle world. The oldest known Mer people, Sirens, come from Greece. And of course, Scotland has Selkies and Ireland is home to Merrows. I could go on for ages about them. Their glorious underwater communities, domestication of sea life, their art and music. It's a travesty how little is understood about them.
Well, I can swim and could help you if you'd like.
You'd really do that? Oh, thank you. Thank you, thank you. The last thing I want is for them to think I'd shunned their gift. Diplomacy is a delicate dance. Now, if I'm not mistaken, I think you can dive down to their cave from just there in the water.
Just where and where and
I
what?
I can't wait to hear about what you find. One day soon, I'll see for myself. I just know it.
Then let's dive. Whoa.
Look at this place. Did the Mer-people really leave Nerida an artifact?
Oh, come on. I cannot. Okay, like that.
Incendio
that, incendio this, incendio everything. For what do we need those butterflies? Oh, right, for those doors.
Now then, I need you to come with me.
Exactly.
Now for the rest of you.
Let's go with me. And the last one over here, boom.
What do we have in here then?
Well, some artifact.
Nerida will be happy about this.
Wow, very nice.
Rebellion.
And like, that's it? Really? Oh, you can't be serious. Oh, but of course I can. Well, alright. I can fly on a broom? Yeah, wow. That's so nice. I didn't knew that. Yeah.
Your gift from the Mer people was exactly where they said it would be.
That's wonderful news. I was so worried I'd left it too long and they'd seen it as a slight. Our relationship with them is already so tenuous.
Then I'm glad we helped to foster some healthy diplomatic relations.
Merlin's beard. It's marvelous. I'm going to show it to everyone, including the ministry. Should I hand deliver or send by owl? Thank you again so much. You may have just helped improve relations between wizardkind and Mer people for decades to come. I can't wait to study this.
No problem.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Yes, I heard that. You are saying this. That's true. Alright, so we did this quest as well. Alright, I guess that's it maybe for this video. Yeah. Let's finish that video in this very lovely place. Just by the water, by the lake. Fantastic. Alright, wizards and witches, thank you for staying with me in that one. I hope you liked it and enjoyed it. If you did, leave some like or comment, and if you are new to my channel, please click the subscribe button. I will be very grateful. And I cannot wait to see you in another episode from Hogwarts Legacy.